Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to play classic arcade and computer games on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So usually when you want to play an old classic game, you either have to find a developer that has created a new version of that game, or perhaps run an emulator on your Mac, which is difficult to do. You've got to install the emulator, then you've got to go and look for the software to install on it. It involves lots of steps and some questionable legalities. But an easy way to do it is actually use the Internet Archive. The Internet Archive has archived many old arcade and computer games in a format that you could play right in the web browser. So it's actually emulating the old arcade cabinet or computer in the browser, and you could just play without installing anything. So the first collection I want to show you is just called Internet Arcade, and it's located here. You're going to see a lot of classic arcade games. It's not a complete list. There's obviously some that have been left out. Maybe they didn't get the rights to use them, but a lot of ones that were my favorites are here. Like, for instance, here's Joust. Now when you go to one of these, it loads up a page with lots of information, and the game is at the top, and you have to click it to actually load the game. I recommend looking at the information first because you're going to find important things like what keys on the keyboard to use to control the game. Sometimes you won't really find that much information, but if you go down to the comments below, you'll find people talking about what works and what doesn't, what keys work best, that kind of thing. I'm going to warn you, it's very frustrating to try to use some of these games. Some features don't work like they used to when these games first were released on the web. So it takes a little patience and experimentation to get each one going. Let's try this one here. I'll click to begin, and I get this little set of controls here that I find just simply don't work. So I dismiss those. It usually loads up the game as if it's an arcade cabinet just starting. So a lot of times you'll end up in a test mode. To get around that, you have to hit a special key. And what that key is, well, you have to kind of guess. I find that a lot of times it's an F key. So you have to hit something like F2 or F5. Of course, depending upon how your keyboard's set up, you may have to hold down the FN key for those F keys to work. So for Joust here, it seems to work if I hold down the FN key and do F2. And then we'll finish booting the machine. Now I have to use the regular number 5 key to insert a coin and 1 for one player. And how I can play. So the left and right arrow keys seem to work pretty well. The control key works for flapping the wings. And you can see here how it conflicts with other things on the Mac. So let me turn that off there so I can actually control. Of course, if I use left and right arrow with the control key, it's also going to activate mission control and try to move over to another desktop. So you may need to disable that so you can see how frustrating this is. But once you put a few minutes of time into learning how each game works, you actually find that they're pretty playable. And they work fine here in Safari as well as other browsers like Chrome and Firefox. One thing you'll find that just doesn't work is sound. So a lot is preventing sound from working in browsers today. And I've never really gotten the sound to work on any of these. You can search for games over here. And as I said, you could find some popular games, not others. So for instance, Tron is there, but you won't find games like Pac-Man. And Tron is one where you really have to go and pay attention to what people say about the keys. If you scroll down, you'll find people giving suggestions about the keys, like using Z and X to simulate the wheel that was on the original arcade cabinet. So I'm going to use 5 here to insert a coin, 1 to play, and then I'm going to go over to the right here to go to the tank game. And now you can see the Z and X will actually turn the turret, and the arrow keys will move the tank. A lot of times it's the control key that acts as the button on the cabinet. But arcade games aren't the only classic computer games that are out there. You can also browse a large library of MS-DOS games here. And you can see this collection is huge. And these games tend to work a little bit better because you're using a keyboard, so it fits a little bit better with the game itself. Here's the original Oregon Trail game. And the keyboard works just fine with these games for the most part. Now how about classic Mac games? Well, there's a collection of those as well, but it's much smaller. And this is actually software, not just games. So you're going to find a lot of different pieces of old Mac software here, even like word processors and things like that. Since these are emulating a Mac, sometimes there's a disk that includes several games on it. Here's a game I played a long time ago, And when you run this, you'll see it actually boot a little Mac emulator here right in your browser. And to actually play the game, you even need to go and use the cursor, open up the little drive, and launch the game by double clicking it. And then you got to kind of remember how to play it. Like for instance, here you go to Game, Start Game, and then you could play and use the I, J, K, and M keys to move around. Now I was trying to remember all the old games I used to play, and I realized that actually a lot of them I didn't play on the early Macs. I played them on the Apple II. So, of course, there is a library of Apple II games. And this one is the largest library of all. It includes lots of software that's not games, though. But I was able to search and find a lot of my favorites, some of them as cracked versions, probably because the originals couldn't be recovered into this format. So here's Spy Hunter, a game I wasted a lot of time on. I found this one took a long time to boot up, but it finally did, and I was able to play. I had to experiment to figure out it's the L and the semicolon keys to move left and right, and the A and the Z key to speed up and break. So while it's great to have all these games available, it can be frustrating to try to figure out how to play. I find it's best to actually just find one game you want to play, really focus on figuring out how it works and getting to play it. If you jump around from game to game, it's just too frustrating. But definitely worthwhile if you're nostalgic for games that you may have played in the arcade or on older computers. And also, if you search, you'll find out the Internet Archive has collections of games from other systems as well. You'll find them, say, for the Commodore 64 or the Atari 800. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.